Hey, how's it going, everyone? Welcome back to another Red Dead Redemption 2 video. My name is Saints Fan, and today I want to show you guys five or so changes that you totally should make to your game settings to get a much smoother experience. One of the main problems, main complaints with RDR2 so far is the controls. Well, with these settings, it doesn't make it perfect, but it makes it much, much better. So, obviously, what we're going to do is hit the start button. We're going to go into the settings, and from here, we're going to go into the controls. Now, there's a lot of confusing wording here, and a lot of it, I mean, it does tell you at the top left what some of these things do, but I'll just run down the five things that you totally should do. So the first two things that you need to do if you're aiming or if you think the gunplay feels a little weird is change your dead zone and your acceleration. These are probably the two most important things in this video. Turn your dead zone all the way down. Normally it's gonna be at about 50%. Turn it all the way down and do this for first person as well. I mean, you might not use first person a lot, but just have it all there across the board. And then for acceleration, you can turn that up all the way. As for the sensitivity, you can just play with that. I would probably recommend having a higher look sensitivity versus a higher aim sensitivity so you're not going all over the place. But those right there, the acceleration and the dead zone, that's like the two most important things. That alone will help the game feel a lot better. The next thing, and this one is going to be somewhat up to you, but the third person, or just the controls in general, for first and for third. It's at standard normally, but if you wanna have a more traditional game control scheme, switch it to the standard FPS. The only thing this changes is the button mashing of A. So we all know, because this is how it is in all Rockstar games, you have to mash the A button to run. Right? To sprint, you have to keep it in the A button. Well, with this standard FPS, that gets rid of that. The hell is... Apparently someone's investigating me. But what this does change it to is the left stick, which is like how it is in most FPS games. So you can now use your left stick for running, and you can hit A to crouch. It will take some time to get used to, trust me. Apparently I've committed murder. But it will take some time to get used to, because you're going to constantly be tapping the A button and your guy's going to be going like up and down. It took me a while to get used to, but I kind of like it a lot better, because now whenever you're on foot, at least you don't need to just constantly smash that A button. Your thumb gets a little break. Now, the unfortunate part about this is that on your horse, you still actually have to hit that A button, the left stick in, just like pet your horse, I think, or I don't even know if it does anything, but you still do need to hit A, tap A on your horse. So that might get a little confusing, but I kind of like it a lot more just because I don't like hitting the A button. And if you lean off the stick, like if you don't push the stick all the way down, the left stick while running, you can see you sort of, you go a little bit slower. So you have some, maybe a little bit more control here in regards to moving. Like, one of the main complaints about the whole control scheme is like when you're in cities and you're sprinting, you always end up boom, 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 running into people and they call it cops. Well, this may help that. Now, back into settings, one of the other things you totally need to change is this in the accessibility. We're still in the controls panel, but the accessibility, turn this to toggle to run. I mean, I guess if you like holding things down to run, you can do that, but toggle to run just makes your life so much easier. You just press the button in and boom, whether you use A to run or the left stick, having the toggle to run just makes life so much easier. And then one other thing I think a lot of people maybe have missed out on is this tap assist. I actually have it off because I don't like spamming the A button to run, but this is actually for those quick time events where you have to like hold the button or keep pressing it to help out. You can actually assist this where you can just hold it instead of tapping it, or you can adjust that. So those are two things you may want to play with, but I would highly recommend putting running mode on toggle. And actually, just quickly talking about the aim assist, you might not want to play with this if you aren't like the super best at aiming. I have mine normal on ground and then wide with it up kind of far on the horse, just because I feel like when you're on a horse, it's going to be a lot harder to aim. So you kind of want that aim assist, but on ground, you don't want it too bad. But you can mess around with this. If you want free aim, you can do that. Narrow makes it a little bit, I guess it makes it a little bit harder. The auto aim isn't as bad, but normal is, I think, probably the better one. The only other thing, and I think it's in camera here, is the camera follow level. This, I think, is at high or low. It's at not a good setting. I ended up changing mine to minimal. And what this does is actually allow, when you're riding on your horse, for the camera to auto turn back. A lot of the times, I'll show you guys here what I'm talking about. You know what? Matter of fact, I'm going to go ahead and put it to high so you can see. If we turn this all the way up to high, then once we get on our horse, wherever the hell it's at, whenever you look to the right, it instantly goes back to the center. So if you're trying to look like, you know, slightly to the left, you really can't, because it quickly goes back to centering it. So if there's, yeah, anything, if you're trying to shoot at someone, it's just very, very, very annoying. So what I'm going to go ahead and do is not go to the map. We're going to go back into settings and put that to minimal. You could put this to off if you don't like that, but I do like occasionally having the thing auto go back. But now at minimal, I can put it here and it takes a minute before it actually goes back. So if there's, you know, someone behind me or to the side of me, I can look, boom, 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 shoot, and it'll slowly turn back. And I like that much better. It feels a lot more smoother, natural, I guess. So those are some settings. Those are about five or so settings that I think you totally should change. Also, if you do play in first person, pump up the field of view a lot, and also turn off head bobbing. Put that to reduce. No one likes head bobbing. But these settings should hopefully make your game feel a lot smoother. Oh, one of the other final tips, and this one I think is the most important tip when you're in cities, especially Saint Denis, go into first person. This is how it was in GTA 5. First person, it may take some time to get used to. It's so much easier to control. And your guy actually, you can see he's sort of running, and I'm not even sprinting. So he goes a little bit faster in first person as well, but it's just easier to control. You can see going left, right, back, forward, where in third person, if we want to go forward, then we want to go back and then right. And then, you know, I'm hitting the wrong buttons now because I'm gotten all confused with my controls. But yeah, you can see you're going all over the place. You're driving and you're spinning circles. First person, just a lot easier to control your guy when you're in cities and even indoors. All right, so that was the tips. Hopefully these helped you guys out. Thank you all for watching. Please drop the video like and share this with everyone so they can know how to make their game feel a lot better. Subscribe also if you're new around here for more awesome RDR2 videos. And as always, I'll see you guys in the next one.